Hello and welcome back to Creative Cat. There are lots of modeling clays available and people get confused about which clay to use. I get questions like, which is the best clay? So it really depends on what you want to make or what you want to achieve. You can't really choose any one type of clay and use it for different kinds of projects. In this video, we will compare few commonly used modeling clays. We will see their pros and cons so that you can choose an ideal clay for your project. I'm sure after watching this video, you won't have any confusion about which clay to use. Comment and let me know how you like this video. Also subscribe to this channel if you haven't yet. Let's start. There are two types of modeling clays, air dry clay and oven dry clay. We are not talking about kids modeling clay or Play-Doh, which is designed to stay wet for longer time. Air dry clay is a type of clay which dries in open air at room temperature without baking. It takes 24 hours to few days to dry depending on thickness and size of your project as well as weather condition. Natural modeling clay, paper clay, homemade cold porcelain clay, Shilpkaar or Mould-it are some examples of air dry clay. Now let's see some pros and cons of air dry clay. Pros are easy to work with, suitable for all ages, inexpensive and normally water based. Most of them you can easily make at home. No need of special glue or special varnish. Cons are all air dry clays shrink about 5 to 25% after drying as the water content gets evaporated. Some clays crack after drying due to shrinkage. Let's see what is oven dry clay. The clay which needs baking in oven to get hard or to cure. It stays soft at room temperature and hardens when baked in oven. Polymer clay is an oven dry clay. This clay also has some pros and cons. The pros are it gets really strong like plastic after curing. It's a plastic based clay. You get lots of time to complete your project as it doesn't dry out while working. Ideal for most of the sculpting project. Available in wide variety of colors and types, doesn't shrinks or cracks. Cons are it's expensive, you can't mix color in it, you need to buy it in different colors. You need special glue and varnish which is compatible with this clay. Needs oven and constant supervision while baking. Now let's see all these clays one by one. Sculpture clay, natural clay or shadow clay. I usually buy ready-made clay, but you can also make the similar clay at home by mixing ceramic powder plus glue or wall putty powder plus glue. I will surely share a recipe soon. This small plate I'm making. You can see it does shrinks a little after drying but takes details really well. Really good for sculpting or clay murals. It's not waterproof, you can paint over it and use almost all kinds of paints. Can use normal craft varnish or even clear wood varnish. These are some projects I made using this clay. You can see detailed video tutorials on my channel. Homemade cold porcelain clay. I have already shared recipe for this clay. You will find link in description box below. This clay shrinks up to 20 to 25% after drying, so I don't really advise to use it for sculpting or murals as it shrinks and leaves cracks, but it is really good for small figurines where you don't have to give layers of clay. You can see the difference in shrinkage. This clay is ideal for flower making. It's really flexible and strong to make those paper thin petals. It's also ideal for jewelry and charms. You can mix paints in it or even paint your project after drying. Paper clay. For this clay also, I have already shared recipe. You can easily make it at home. It's strong and ideal for big projects. You can add more wall putty or ceramic powder to make it more smooth. This is just paper and little flowers, so it is not much smoother. You can see it on this plate. The recipe which I follow doesn't crack or doesn't streak much. You can paint over it after drying. It's really strong and lightweight, ideal for big projects. If you don't need very fine details, then go for it. These are some projects I made with this clay. This design I made. Salt dough, all-purpose flour or maida clay. I've shared recipe for this too. Its main ingredients are all-purpose flour or maida and salt. It normally gets used for kids projects and Christmas ornaments. Salt works as preservative, but because of high amount of salt, it easily get affected with moisture in air. So if it is raining or it's humid climate, then please don't make this clay, especially in country like India. It won't dry easily. It can be oven dry, but you will need to cover it immediately after drying. This clay also shrinks after drying up to 5 to 10%. You can make such kind of projects. You can add color in it or paint over it. Next is polymer clay. I don't really use it much as I prefer my homemade clay over it. So I have only one color to show you right now. This clay doesn't shrink or cracks, and you will need oven to dry it. Takes details really well. You can paint over it. Basically, your project turns into plastic-like material after baking. I have few projects made using this clay to show you. This clay is best for jewelry and figurines. So these 5 clays we saw today, I made these small dishes using same cutter, and you can see after drying how they change shape and their texture. This is polymer clay which doesn't change shape. This is paper clay, natural modeling clay, salt dough and handmade cold porcelain. I told you what you can make from all these clays, so now you can choose ideal clay for your project.
If you love this video, please hit like, share, comment, subscribe and don't forget to press bell icon to get updated about new uploads. Thank you so much. Bye bye.